All right, well, first of all, congratulations. I saw the movie last night. So fun, so smart. You get the call that you're going to play Barbie or Alan.
Right.
What was that like in that first moment for you?
Just like the privilege of a lifetime, honestly. Like, yeah. When I heard that Greta was doing it, I was like,
you're kidding me. What? And you're calling me?
Right.
I think that's what I actually said.
And did they tell you in that same call that you were playing Weird Barbie?
Yes. And then I went, oh, what?
Kind of like that.
Similar to that? Okay, got it. I've got a visual. Yeah. What about you, Michael?
I made a noise kind of like that. Kind of like that.
Yeah, similar. Isa?
Yeah, I had less sounds. My breath was taken away.
Okay.
And I was just really excited about, you know, the prospect of playing a Barbie. I never imagined that for myself.
Mm. I mean, and to speak to that just a little bit more, never having imagined it and to now be a part of it and in such a front row center way, what does that mean to you, just period, particularly from the lens of representation?
For me, it just feels like a Letterman's jacket in a way, where it's just like, oh, I can claim, you know, I played for a pink team. I don't know. It just feels cool to be a part, especially thinking about, you know, who the cast is. And it just feels like we're part of something special and hopefully more to come.
Absolutely. Now, how much say did each of you have in your characters, in the type of Barbie or Alan that you were?
Well, for me, the script was like all there. Like, I didn't feel the need to change or add to anything. It was like so fully realized. Right. And we just talked about what the look would be, and that was such a fun back and forth of imagining what sort of, the only question was like, usually weird Barbies are naked, and so I was like, should I be like fully splayed? And like, she was like, I don't think that's the tone of the film. And I was like, okay, what don't you want about that? But, you know, and we had a big fight, but then it was, she convinced me, you know, wear clothes. Don't. And I was like, fine.
Your movie, your career.
Yeah.
Your movie, your career. Exactly. The splits. I mean, how much stretching was involved preparing for this role? I mean, at a certain point, this has to be CGI, right?
Those were fake splits.
Okay.
It was, one leg was real, one was hidden, and then there was a fake leg.
Wonderful.
Here.
I love
Incredible.
That.
So I can't do much more.
That was already pretty good.
I want you to own that you did these splits in a movie, please. Just once.
Wait, did she really?
Yeah, she did. She is so... She is the most flexible person I've ever met. In mind and spirit and body. Yeah.
In mind, spirit, and body. Mm-hmm. It's holistic flexibility. That's a beautiful thing. Uh-huh.
And I was like, you sure you want me in clothes? And she was like, yes. And I was like, okay.
So you kept revisiting it, sort of thing.
Just kept checking in. And that was still the mandate.
Because, like, this would be really cool right now. Sure. Can we just try it out?
But no, it's hard no. Okay. Well, it turned out how it should have, and I thought everyone was brilliant in it. Let's talk about President Barbie for a minute here. Talk to me a little bit about that character, right? And also, I heard that you played a hand in President being in a ball gown. Is that right?
Yes. Greta was very much open to President Barbie's wardrobe and, you know, how she presented herself, who she was. I think, like, to Kate's point, she was just super collaborative. And she also had us each imagine who was playing with our individual Barbies. Mm. So I envisioned my childhood. So Hari's was my favorite. You know, her Barbie is a gay man who collects Barbies.
Okay.
And so
that's
to me, yes, that's who's playing with her or has her on the shelf.
Okay.
So I just, for me, I thought too small, you know, after that I heard that.
You gotta think big.
Gotta think big.
You know, Barbie and Ken, obviously, Ryan and Margot. What was it like seeing them on set? Why are they the perfect Barbie and Ken for this?
They're beautiful people.
Yeah.
They look like chiseled dolls to begin with.
Yeah.
But they're also just so personable. And you could watch them all day. It was really, really fun. I think one of my first or second day was just watching Ryan find Ken and play with his voice and play with his emotions. And it was, no one else could have embodied that Ken the way he did.
Yeah. There's one day where Ryan has a monologue where he's wearing a fur jacket.
Yep. And we
did a lot. I mean, we did it, I think, over 2 or 3 days, actually. And we all basically were just watching Ryan do this monologue over and over. And it was really incredible.
Yeah.
Really, after every take, we were just like, oh, my God.
Yeah.
I cannot believe what I'm seeing, what he's doing.
I can only imagine what that looked like up close and personal. Yeah. It was great as a viewer to really see the final iteration of it.
Yeah.
I'm curious for you, though, Michael. Okay, so someone's playing with the Allen doll.
Mm-hmm.
Who's that?
Mm.
Someone who likes to probably hide in the corner and just have their little Allen and hang out. And Allen doesn't demand too much from them or from their imagination. he could just be there. He's sort of just a presence. The kid who doesn't want to think too hard about what they're doing.
Oh my God, my producer's gonna kill me because the laughing is eating time and I can't stop. Oh, okay. No, thank you for painting that picture. I see that child and I want to give them a hug.
You know that guy.
Yeah, I think we all do.
Yeah.
We heard about the Barbie sleepover. That sounded pretty epic. What can you tell us about the Barbie sleepover? We heard the Kins were invited, but they had to go.
Yeah.
The ladies got to party through the night.
I think you're talking to the 3 people who didn't go.
No,
I wasn't in town.
I'm just hearing about it.
Yeah. It was, I heard about it on the day. I heard it was really fun. I was like, good for you guys. You know, Barbie click, fine. Barbie bitches had a great time. No, I was happy for them. It seemed like a great bonding opportunity. Uh-huh.
For those who were involved.
Yes.
Okay, now I wouldn't know.
Before I had arrived.
Wait, what?
I think I had arrived into town just a few days after, and I was hearing
same.
About it.
Oh,
I was hearing rumblings of it. It was supposed to be really fun.
Yeah.
Okay, allegedly, supposedly.
Yeah.
Okay. Barbie, did you have one growing up, play with Barbies?
I did not have Barbies.
No.
I had seashells, rocks.
Okay.
Stuffed animals, stethoscopes. You
okay.
know, I don't know. I had it all, just not Barbie.
Just not a Barbie.
I would have fit a Barbie into all that. It would have added some color.
What did you do with the rocks?
Just sort of arrange them.
As one does.
Yeah, just made scenes.
Just scenes for myself. I have to go. The wrapping.